Welcome back to the channel, everybody. This is Lady Naka, and with another reality TV review. And this time, we are talking about love and hip-hop Hollywood. Be not disturbed. There ain't nothing wrong with me, y'all. It's that monthly time where I have to come get my infusion, and I figure if I'm going to try to get some videos out, I'm not doing nothing right now, so today would be a good day to start. It's all good. We all good. We at our regular spot doing what we do. Me and Dean, you know how it go. But anyway, now, I don't remember this shit in order. Well, I'm going to keep it 100. I don't remember this stuff in order, but I'm going to try to get it to you the best way I know how, okay? I do remember what happened. I just don't remember it in order. Now, we're going to start off back over there at the studio. Y'all remember last week, old girl, Lil Brainless went over there trying to catch up with her husband in the studio and see what kind of, you know, haps be going on with the house, okay? And she had old Plastique with her. Well, of course, Plastique stood in the background like she always do, because she ain't about that life at all. She, you know, certain things I like about Plastique, certain things I don't like about old Plastique, but she wasn't trying to get in none of the business. Well, old girl done busted the heck and a fool telling, the young lady that was close to her husband to get her hands off her man, and that's a married man, and the reason why you don't know that the man is married. And y'all, did she not dig in that purse for about 25 minutes? Child, I was kidding myself. Girl, if you came with it on your mind to get in his ass about not having that ring on and catching him with women, that ring should have been in the safe deposit box, or it should have been in your, you know, you know, jacket or something you had on. Fatigue like you was prepared to go to war. You should have had that ring on the man, baby, for you to spend all that time digging down in that purse only further prove that you are truly Lil Brainless. So with that being said, this man basically was looking at you like, girl, here you go again, dying him on my job with the fool of fuck shit. And with that, he started to walk off from you because he ain't got time for that. Girl, let me tell you something. If a man don't want you, ain't nothing you can do about that. You need to get that through your head. Now, he was tolerating you, okay? But you couldn't take the fact that he told you he ain't want you no more. So, you sitting there trying to follow him. Well, he told you he ain't want to hit it. He walking out the building with a little smirk on his face like, bruh. Yeah, I got to keep putting up with this. Hell to no. Well, apparently, kid, we're going to stick with them. I'm going to go and get them all out the way. Well, after she cut a fool down at studio time, I guess he didn't come home for a couple of days. And, of course, you know, if she ain't took her psych med, she probably, you know, I told y'all she got one banana peel, one foot on a banana peel in the wood from being on the psych ward anyway. She sitting up there, child, all up in her feelings. This man that come home after a couple of days of being gone, he speak to her, and the only thing she can do is start the drama about what he do. You been with this man 11 years, you know what he do. Girl, I don't see no similar, I don't see nothing about you that say Whitney or Houston, other than the fact that you and her may favor the white girl. That's the only thing I see y'all might have in common, because, honey, That cutting up you like to do. See, you couldn't cut up with me like that. Because I think any other, you know, tell you the truth, them cameras running on, he'd probably whooped your ass. But he didn't. He going on about his business. You still in there with that crazy talk. So he told you, you know what, I think I need some. I don't need this type of, you know, foolery in my life. So I'm probably going to need to be on by myself. Y'all, when I tell you, this girl act like she was having Tourette's syndrome. She act like she had Tourette's syndrome, a seizure, and what we call a good old-fashioned fit at the same time. She went to shaking and shivering like she had been delivered, child. I'm like, look at this fool here. This fool is actually acting up, because this man saying that he think that he might need to be alone. Well, when he said he couldn't get no conversation with her that was logical, he got up to leave. Now, you one would think at that point she was going on about her business, right? Child, no. Here she go, wants to follow him outside, but then gonna tell him, don't embarrass her in front of the neighbors. You see the neighbor just pulled up across the street. Girl, go in your house and stop acting a fool with this man. You act a fool in front of his colleagues. What makes you think he ain't gonna show his ass out there in front of y'all next? And he did, because he let them all know that we got problems too. And then he told her, if this ring means so much to you, here it is. And baby, why did he throw that ring like he was Michael Vick throwing for them Pittsburgh Steelers? Can you tell me why? Child, I hollered. I said, girl, go get your ring. But child, she probably can't find that ring. But right that moment, baby, he had shocked her world. And I don't know why she was so shocked, because it looked like he got a habit of doing these things to you. So why are you shocked? Because he finally just told you that he don't want to play no more. Girl, when a man don't want to play no more, you can't make that man play no more. If he don't want to play no more, what's wrong with you? Little brains. Child, that man was trying to go across the street getting his home, and that right there in itself says, because why was he, if he lived with you and that's y'all place, why was he parked across the street? But he goes to try to leave, honey, and I'm telling you, little brain has followed him. Thought she was going to stand in front of that car. Not from where I'm from, a nigga probably would have ran her ass over. Anybody knowing me, if it would have been me, I probably would have hit her. But he showed her, girl, you cannot control me. Because he put that thing in reverse and rolled out on her anyway. Going only to prove that you cannot threaten, harass, buy, or force love. So what you might want to do is, first of all, go see you somebody, babe. I think it's time for her to go sit on the couch and have a conversation. Because all her life gone. He snatched her whole world with just that one move by putting that car in reverse and leaving her standing over there. Child, I don't know what to tell you about that dumb ass hoe, but I tell you what I can tell you. Child, in the words of Sean Bradley, it ain't safe in a world full of delusional, lonely bitches. Moving along. Okay, so next we're gonna talk about Princess and Ray J. Now Ray J all up in his feelings, and I can understand why in this case. Because Princess and Ray and Tiara don't need to be friends. First of all, I believe sincerely that Princess probably did reach out to this girl and was real about wanting to become friends with her. But rule number one, you don't never motherfucking try to befriend the bitch that used to fuck your dick. Okay? And clearly from last season, you see Tiara still running around here like she can't get past him. Look at her now. It's a big difference between who she was and who she is now. Tiara is double stuffed. Tiara look uncomfortable with that damn in her neck. Running around here, ain't got nothing but head and shoulders. Are you kidding me? Well, he telling her he want her to go back to her old self. And then I understand what she mean. Why should I not go out and have fun with my friends, but you can do all of that? What he should have said is, can you not be friends with my ex because I don't trust her? Which probably would have prompted her to want to do it anyway. But, you know, at least let's just be real. You cannot domesticate a woman in 2015. How you gonna take her back? You done took her back almost 30, 40 years trying to make her stay in a house that you can go out and turn up and lay up with all the good little girls, all of the girls you want to. I don't understand why these girls go crazy for Ray J. I don't mean no harm, but he's a bitch boy. He a fuck boy to me. I don't care how good the dick might be. It ain't never worth yourself, your pride and your self-esteem. Why are y'all giving this man this much power over you? And I'm glad to see that old princess is getting her senses and not quite falling for the okie doke and staying in the house. And, you know what I'm saying? Girl, I don't know what you do for a living, because look like to me, what you do is you lay on your back. But you must be good at what you do, because you had people like Floyd Mayweather on your team, you know what I'm saying? And you know, Floyd take care of his house, okay? I don't know what prompted you to go on and hook up with Sister Ray J, but whatever. Ain't no way in hell if I'm a bitch running around here with no employable skills, am I going to be selling for a Ray J? Girl, if your monkey is your business, is your market, is your main source of income. You better use that thing to what it's supposed to be used for, honey. You better use that and come up on your own and stop laying off these celebrities. Now, I ain't saying that, you know, I ain't judging you if you're using the cooch. I'm just saying if you're going to use the puss and invest in you. Okay, stop laying up just using your good shit, getting these men all that good stuff, and they ain't giving you nothing in return but the right now. So I'm here for you when you told him Princess is still, the old Princess is still here. I'm just not going to be staying up in this house, especially without the benefit of a ring and a piece of paper. Girl, he'll have to put something in paper. You got to put it on paper for me. If you want me to act 100% right, you better put some paperwork down saying exactly where I stand with this thing. Because up until that point, just ain't no telling, honey. There just ain't no telling with me, okay? Well, later on, April meets up with Princess. And Princess is telling her that she feels that Double Stuff might be betraying her. You think, bitch? Dude, you really think? You're out there. You look like you Asian and black. You ain't, when it comes to using your brain, you ain't channeling none of your Asian side, huh? Now, I ain't saying black is stupid, but let's just be real. Them Asian people are some little geniuses. She ain't got none of that. I mean, even with Lisa Wu over there on the Hollywood Divas, we might have talked about it and said, you know, she was a cheap-ass hoe, but she was cheap-ass hoe with a plan. This ain't got no damn friend. This ain't showing none of her. Hey, girl, can I get some of that Asian that you got in you to see through and maybe break through to give you some common sense? Because I think he got a wall of cum blocking your common sense that he done put up in you. I'm going to need you to do better, bitch. Do better. Well, she telling April that she think that Double Stuff betraying her because she going back telling Ray Stuff. Do you really think? And April saying, well, if she doing this, she need to be slapped. Okay, now, April, I'm glad you stood back and said I'm going to stay neutral because that's what you need to do. Now, I honestly think you might be by them hands, but why get in there, miss, because it ain't your business, you know. You can't care. Although we love our friends, we can't always get involved in their mess and stuff like that. So don't you get in there, girl. But to Princess, yeah, you need to slap Tara. You need to slap Tara 35 times, too. Because, to be honest, I heard some other reviewers saying that they felt like Princess ain't ready for Double Stuff. Oh, baby, the Double Stuff done got slow. Let me tell you one thing about eating them Double Stuff cookies and them snacks, them Little Debbie's. Baby, Little Debbie makes you be Deborah. And them Double Stuff Oreos make you head and shoulders. And tell me if she ain't. I know I'm a thick chick, but y'all, I still got a neck. Tara ain't got no damn neck. She ate so much shit. All behind depression over this man. Well, Princess decides she gonna set up a little something on her to see if she really a friend or is she a foe, right? So she gone on over there and decided to send a text message telling her that she going to Vegas for the weekend and do she wanna go. Now, we're going to see how she going to bite. Now, Miles meets up with 2K and Sam because he kind of concerned because his boo Milan has not been returning his calls. And I'm sitting here thinking to myself, child, what would make you think he would want to answer your phone call? The man should have been financing you, romancing you, giving you all that good stuff he got, you know what I'm saying? And you treat him like an afterthought, you know? You're not keeping it 1,000 with him. So why would he answer your phone call? So, you know, he want to go in the studio, so he feeling some kind of way. So he going to have to go on and figure out how to fix that situation because, child, he can't survive without her. He ain't going to be able to make none of that music we ain't never going to hear if he can't get in that studio. You know what I'm saying? So he gonna go on and try to make things right. And Hazel gave him a good advice. You know, you gotta come correct with him. You can't treat him like that. So he decided he gonna set up a romantic dinner with him. You know, the cozy spot somewhere out there in the L.A. Hollywood area. And And basically, he presents Milan with a tattoo of a crown with Eminem in that. And for reasons unknown, Milan fell for the fuck shit and thought that was a beautiful thing. I guess he felt like some kind of way that, you know, at least he's starting to come around to want to be more accepting. Here we are at dinner together, and then he's put this tattoo. Which, I'm sure he took the block he had off of the debit card so the boy could use it again and put it. Miles gave him an old healthy kiss in his mouth in front of a few people. And Milan was blown away by that and impressed. But my thing is, why the fuck are you impressed when them people sitting around y'all ain't nothing but fucking extras? Child, ain't like he took you out amongst some regular everyday people. Every last one of them people that was sitting around y'all was on the payroll of Love and Hip Hop Hollywood, aka Mona Scott Young. So good try, Mona, bitch. You gotta get up a little bit earlier in the morning than to pull one over a bitch like mine, like me. I saw you, bitch. I saw you for your work. Them weren't no everyday regular people he did that in front of. But, of course, Milan is like, do you realize you kissed me in front of the real people? Because that's what I was thinking. That was some extras. He's like, do you realize that you kissed me in public? And he's like, nah, fuck it. He's conflicted, child. Plus, when he was talking to Hazel Miles, he said that he was conflicted because he used to be a youth minister. Child. I could say so much, but I'm not going to go there because I don't feel like arguing down in my comment section. But, baby, let me tell you something. Just about all, everybody, it's a lot more queens in the church than you realize. And Iyana just did a 2 or 3 part series about two in particular. Baby, I can look at Milan. Now, I'm not saying that he's not masculine. I'm just saying he look like he a tambourine holder. That's all I'm saying. I don't understand why it wasn't evident. It really is. I mean, if you look at him, and y'all know I love me some LGBTQ community people, because hell, my daughter's a member of it. But let's just be 1,000 here. That motherfucker look like he a tambourine hole. Hey, talking about he used to be a youth minister too. Well, baby, I'm going to tell you like this right here. God made us all, and from what they tell me, say he don't make no mistake. So if you a tambourine holder, be proud and hold your tambourine. That's all I'm gonna say. Anyway, apparently he gonna take that block off that debit card so this boy can go to the studio, because that's what all this is about, honey. Well, let's go on over here to the transgender crazy-ass Monique and Double Stuff having a little meet-up conversation, girl time talk, whatever you want to call these tricks, they hooking up. And they over there, she over there telling, Tierra is telling them, old Double Stuff say she thinks she got Princess believing that she her BFF, and I'm sitting here thinking to myself, girl, you okay, you read what you saw. You read what you saw, because this girl genuinely tried to be cool with you, and you sitting here trying to help tear her relationship down, not realizing the little gay boy is still going to be with you, girl. It don't matter if he with Princess or not, he is not going to come back to you. You should be used to that by now. I don't even remember the time frame that you was actually supposed to be with Ray Ray. But I tell you this. Sitting up blowing up like a balloon ain't gonna help the situation none at all. And being an evil bitch ain't gonna get you nothing either. Focus on you and get your mind off that young man, because apparently he don't want you, Gary. You ain't got that Midas touch no more. Maybe your push just ain't better than her, because he don't love neither one of y'all, but I think he would be more apt to want to be with Princess than you. And he sure gonna want to be with Princess more than you now. Girl, you done sit up there and got, you done lost your neck. That's why I call you Double Stuff, like you hoe. You just look like one of them big old, she look like the vanilla Oreo stuff, cause she ain't dog. But anyway, child, she in there telling them folks about she thinks she got this girl, thinking that they BFF, and she don't know if she should tell Ray about this text message the girl, sent her, inviting her to Las Vegas for the weekend. Now, Monique, even the crazy one, told you, girl, it could be a setup. And you didn't take heed of what your friends was telling you. You decided that you was going to go on down that one and send that text message to Ray, thus feeding right into what Princess thought of you. And later on, we're going to see y'all have y'all confrontation. Well, let's roll on over here to Kamaya, another strong faith bitch they got on this motherfucker. You know the girl that told told Lil Fizzy Boy last week she ain't want to be no appetizer, she's a main course. Well, she meet up with this, apparently this Atlanta blogger who, from what I checked him, he ain't even verified on Twitter, but okay, meeting up with him, and he asking, you know, about how she doing, and she let him know that, you know, her and Fizz ain't really kicking it no more, and for some reason, the queen wanted to know about their sex life, and Kamaya just basically said that, you know, sometimes he can't get it up, you know, and maybe it's because he getting toward his 30s. My thing is this, girl, that boy can't get it up, because weed is a happy drug, but it's also an unhappy drug when it comes to sex, okay? Some men can keep it going, some men can't. And Fizz be so high all the time, that's why he having, you know, impetus. Child, he don't need nothing but a Viagra. One, okay? One. Y'all, I'm going to have to come tell y'all about that story. Motherfucker overtook them damn Viagras. But anyway, had me sitting up in the emergency room down there 4 or 5 hours. Cause you done overtook Viagra pills trying to be all you can be. But anyway, he over here, well, she done told him that, right? So he done took this little tea and he can't sit on it. He wants to try to prove that, you know, I don't know where he came from. Because from just looking at him with that struggle mohawk, and them bad features he had, I wasn't here for him, and I knew I wasn't going to like him. And he only proved that later on. Later on, we see him meeting up with Nikki, and Nikki want him and Hazel, Toucan Sam, to work with her on her, you know, getting her lingerie line out. And immediately before Hazel could get there, he gets to running down Hazel, talking about her real bad. Now, I ain't never here for Toucan Sam, because I think that she don't know her worth neither. But one thing I do know is, she ain't malicious like that. So, I don't know why he was sitting up there being such a bitch about it. I wasn't here for that. I didn't feel that at all. But, yeah, he did it anyway. And as soon as the girl get there, it's like they get into an argument. Now, he run around here saying that, you know, he done work with people like Bossip and all of that. But, bitch, Bossip clowned you on Twitter the other day. They don't know you. You have no resume. You ain't got no deed or nothing, honey. You ain't got nothing to prove who you say you are. Now, it's to my understanding you are some low-budget Atlanta blogger, but my thing is, what made you think that you could come on this show and mistreat that woman to the degree that you did, and we was going to go up for you? And we don't dislike you because you was a holy queen. We dislike you because you just a broke down bitch. And it's a sorry motherfucker that would attack a female the way you did Hazel. Because the only reason why you threw that drink in her face is because her words hit home. You can't take nothing from her. You act like she a old chick and going through changes. Nah, boo. She young, so she done been through some struggles. What's the problem with a struggle? At least she maintaining. She maintaining well. You hated on her, and then you started the argument, couldn't take the argument, and then got mad at her. He another one with no neck. Always got something to talk about. Yeah, I may not have, I got a neck, but I might be a little, you know, in the fat girl club, but I tell you this much, I know when and where to run my mouth at, and if I'm going to come for you, baby, I'm going to make sure that I get you somewhere you can't come back on me. And when Hazel tried to dig up in his ass, something he ought to be used to by now, he couldn't take it. He wants to dash water in her face. And that is where I say that all the male castmates and security should have whooped his ass. But okay, Mona, that ain't what we looking for. That ain't what it do this season, honey. That'll make people not want to watch this franchise. Because we don't do niggas jumping on bitches. Now, I don't like no bitch jumping on no man either. But that girl didn't do nothing to deserve that. And for the most part, she really don't ever bother nobody. Everybody always disrespecting that girl and think she's supposed to take it. I don't know what you gonna do, Hazel, but I would have cut him from his asshole to his appetite. Now, he probably used to shit being in his ass, but he wouldn't have been used to me cutting him around that soap carrier. Oh, I'd have found his throat, baby. I would have found his throat. He would not have touched me. Not me. Girl, you bet me. And I wouldn't left no show because you are a star or you are a castmate. He is a non-existent cameo appearing from a bitch that don't nobody know. And apparently nobody, you tried it with that, Jason. You tried it with that. It ain't no way, babe. I would have been sitting up in the county jail right now. And they would have still been trying to find all the stab wounds and bullet wounds that I done put in you. Because you, what you won't do is, you won't throw no kind of drink in my face. Not no water. Not no ginger ale. Not no none of them will beat your ass. That's what's going to happen. We would have fought. You act like a girl, I would have took it there with you like a girl. And Nikki, you ain't shit for that. Now that's why I was glad what happened to you. Because we're going to go on over here to the club. And here go Fizz trying to look at coming to holler at Nikki. And see, this is what I don't like about Fizz. Fizz look like he's thirsty. He look like all he look at women nowadays and see is his next conquest. And I don't like a man like that. But maybe some, child, you a waste of good. Well, they say you ain't got no dick. I don't do light bright, so I don't know. And he decide, you know, he wants to try to holler back at Nikki. He can go so far as to tell April he want to get back with her because she's an honest person. April said, yes, she's an honest person, but she got a big ass too. And that's what it's all about. It's about the sex. Well, apparently Nikki don't like Kamaya because apparently Kamaya ain't been talking about her, saying that, well, I tell me it ain't, she ain't talking about her. I mean, I call the girl plastic because she had so many operations done to tuck this, fix this, lift that. So, old girl supposedly done said all these things about her on social media. Y'all need to realize one thing about social media. If you can't stand to be talked about on social media, delete your accounts and move on with your life, because that's what they do. Now, is it always warranted? No, but that's what they do. So Fizz invites her on over there to his house, you know, to as old girl is coming over to get her the rest of her belongings. Now, girl, I thought you said you was coming that day to get them belongings, but I see you did. Belongings, you come. And when she get there, she looking like, what? She kind of feeling some way, because why you got Nikki up in here? Well, Nikki can't just stay silent like, you know, a bitch supposed to do, know her place. She wants to tell the girl that she don't appreciate her talking about her on social media. Nikki, you know you're not about that. Like, girl, if that girl hit you, you are going to melt. Plastic, please stop that. Please stop acting like all y'all that's acting like y'all about that life. Stop that. Because y'all know y'all ain't going to bust a great better child, please. Whatever. They ain't going to do nothing. Anytime a person act like they about that life, 9 times of 10, unless you try them, you try them or you know of them being tried, they usually full of that fuck shit, okay? Well, they get into it because Nikki going to tell her, here go a care package to take to the next guy house you're trying to move into. And Fizz was down with that, sitting over there looking like a sorry ass. Child, he like a broke down with that motherfucker named DJ Quick. You like a broke down DJ Quick. In between all that, they had went to the movies too, child. But anyway, I don't give a fuck about that. The end of the scene was good. Basically, it was, come on, you're proving to Nikki you ain't about that life, because she threw shit at you not once but twice. And if security wasn't there, she would have hit you and fucked up all that work you had done. Girls, don't be putting yourself in situations you ain't ready for. Because you know if that girl get hold of you, you're going to have to be rushed to the emergency room, double over in pain, just like Portia would when Cynthia Jet Li kicked her in her pussy. Child, Fizz called himself, man, he gonna pull her out. Let me tell you something, Fizz. You's a fuckboy. What you need to do is raise your son and revitalize that dead ass career of yours and learn how to use the little pole that you have, because I sink the dick, bitch. I sink the pig. And you not working with me. And now don't nobody believe that story of Nikki and you. Because look at the person she was with last season and look at who she messing with. Talking about messing with you. You are not that Molly Mall was nobody, but child, at least he was bigger than her. Up against you, she look like a giant. And what can you bring to the table? Because we know you done spent, oh, maybe that cinema, that theater that you own half of helping you out along with the VH1 check. But we know you done been spent up your BTK check, that Libby that they, oh boy, let y'all have after you got through fucking y'all. And with that being said, please like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you guys on the next video. Peace.